to talk about how can we cut costs. So let's go and let's work on that.
Since we can't set our income really right now, and until hubby establishes his business, we gotta go by our lowest month. And so our lowest month, we gotta go by that. Now, I'm not gonna give you specific figures simply because YouTube does not like that. But what can we cut our costs on? I don't have a cell phone. I don't have cable, TV. I don't have a lot of things, but our electricity is about $100 a month. Now, a lot of people would say that's pretty high. We live in a mobile home, and for some reason, mobile homes seem to have a high electricity. I'm gonna cut that down to 50. So how are we gonna cut this down to 50? Well, I'm not gonna use lights anymore. I'm not gonna use lights for my videos. I'm gonna go back to how I used to do things. So we're gonna cut our electricity. I'm gonna start thinking about other ways that I can cut our cost. Talk about food. As you all know, I have a lot of food. Now, food budget is gonna be really low for us because you guys all know. You guys know I have more canned food than I could possibly eat in 1 year or 2 years. So we're gonna go with that. But I'm gonna share with you something that I did yesterday, and that will help us with our food. So we're gonna talk about that in a minute. I have one other form of income, and it's not really income, and that is Amazon affiliate. So what does my Amazon affiliate do? That gives me not a paycheck, but it gives me credit. So the Amazon credit is each month. Now, of course, that really varies as well. But the Amazon credit, let's say it's $50 a month. That's $50 I can use for essential items that are non-food. So if there's essential items that we need that's not food-wise, I can use my Amazon credit for that. So I figured out that I could cut my electricity back. You know, I'm gonna be really strong on the $50 a month. So that's gonna be extreme. And we're gonna see what we can do with that. The food, so as you know, I have a food pantry. I got lots of food. But I did put in all of my information at the local food pantry. And the local food pantry is really small. They get hardly anybody. And they have a lot of food. And so I'm going to use the food pantry. It can only go twice a month. And I'm going to use the food pantry for milk and for some fruit that we can't get here in the homestead that I can't grow. But milk and fruit. So the milk and fruit. And I'm going to also show you that. This is going to be very interesting videos because I'm just going to share with you everything. I'm going to take the stigma out of it. I'll be honest with you. I have never been to a food pantry. You have seen many videos of me with loads and loads of food. That was never from the food pantry. That was actually food called a food truck, a vegetable truck that gathered leftover food. And they are going to open up again. But I've never been to a food pantry. So I'll talk to you a little bit in front of the camera about the Amazon affiliate. So the Amazon affiliate, you all know what that is. So I'm not going into that. So if I get $50 a month, that I'm gonna be keeping in there. Now that is not money that is paid to me, that's credit. So for me having the storefront or people buying things from whatever, with Amazon, Amazon then gives me a little bit money back. And most YouTubers have that. And it's another way that it just can help the YouTuber out and it doesn't cost you anything. And you know what? I think it's a great program because it helps both people. A lot of times people will watch a video, but they don't have money. They don't have money to donate, which I totally understand. But yet they buy something on Amazon. They just use that person's Amazon affiliate. And then they, in turn, help that person. So I think it's a win-win. And there's nothing embarrassing about having that at all. So here we go. So this is part two. And this is the whole backdrop. We're not going to go into this again. And then the next week will be part three, where I'm going to share with you. I'm not going to say exactly the titles of it because, you know, this is going to be my ideas. These are my things I'm working on. And so I'm really excited about that. The electricity is going to be really pushing me hard because I do use lights when I have the camera inside the house. Now it's summertime, it's easy to have outdoor lighting, but I think if I can cut back my lights, cut back most of my appliances that would be considered electrical. I had a YouTube channel. I lived a very primitive lifestyle because I didn't have extra things. And then when I got my YouTube channel, 90% of all of the things that would be considered modern were product reviews. If you go to my product review videos, and it was a real blessing to me, you know, having the air fryers and having all of the things, that is a real blessing to me. But it takes electricity, and right now we're gonna be eliminating everything. So if you lose your job, what do you do? First thing you do is you don't panic. You don't panic. You don't get yourself worked up and get yourself anxiety. The first thing you wanna do is you wanna think with a clear head. Okay, what money do you have? Is there any money coming in? Then you wanna think, is there any money that you can save? A penny saved is a penny earned. Now, a lot of people, they don't live like me. A lot of people have all these things. A lot of people have central air conditioning. A lot of people have stuff and they need to have that. You gotta figure out what is your needs and what is your wants. Cable TV, is that a need or is that a want? When I'm talking about this, I'm referring to if you lose your job or if you lose income, what do you do? Especially if you're over 55 years old. You know, what do you do? My husband is a few years older than me. And so the older you get, the harder it is to bring back income in your life. For me, I would rather eliminate income than to go out in the rat race and just totally destroy your body to try to make money. That's my philosophy. I'd rather have my husband home more and then save money than to tell my husband, you gotta go back out and you gotta work 80 hours a week. I would rather say, I wanna live less and have you home more. That's just my philosophy. But that's all depends on what you are. Maybe you're a go-getter. Maybe when you lose your paycheck, you wanna even make more than ever. That's just a different opinion that people have. So this is what we're gonna do, and I'm gonna take you along with me. I know this is a longer video. It had to be longer because I had to share with you the whole story, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So we're gonna work on the electricity. I'm gonna think of anything else because there's just nothing else left to think about. There's just absolutely nothing else. You know, we went to bare bones many years ago, 20 years ago, and we learned our lesson because we're never going back. We saved enough money that we paid for this property with cash, and we have this cash, we have this property free and clear. Everything we have is free and clear. That makes a huge difference. Our property taxes are very low here. Are we ready for the challenge? Are we ready to take our lemons of our life and make lemonade with it? Are we ready to figure out what life's gonna be about? You know, it's really up to this. I'm going to practice more what I've been preaching. So my videos are gonna be more old-fashioned. I'm sharing with you a video coming up because that video I had already pre-recorded about how I'm not gonna do product reviews for China anymore. I'm not gonna do product reviews unless it's something I absolutely need, like the bed that we got, which is absolutely amazing. Now I'm getting into that video, so. Maybe you guys have ideas. You know, this is community channel, people. Maybe you have ideas. Now, I know a lot of you talked about me selling products that I make. I understand that. But at this point in my life, I'm not gonna go into that route. I would go into that route if I just absolutely had to. But right now, I'm just gonna be working on my YouTube channel and just sharing with all of you my life. I can't do both. I don't have time to do both. And right now, I just feel in my heart a real need and calling in this day and age to share with everybody what we're going through and things that we are doing that maybe can help others. Now, I'm not gonna flood my channel with all of this. I'm only gonna do one video a week simply because we wanna do the cooking yet. We wanna have all of my gardening, my herbs, and all of that. So this is only begun one day a week. But I think it's gonna be very interesting because you just don't know. We don't know. We don't know what's gonna happen. And you know, I wanna say one more thing. So many times people told me in the past, you know, aren't you ever afraid if you would lose your income and you only had one income, what would you do? And you know what? I will be totally honest with you. Things would be really, really hard. If this happened and I didn't have YouTube ad revenue, 99.9% of all the money I get is with YouTube ad revenue. And you know what? You're right. You're right about that. But we would have to be dipping into that, and you know how quick money can go. And so I'm so utterly thankful for all of you who watch my videos. I'm really, really thankful for all of you, because you guys are enjoying my life and you're enjoying the lessons that I teach, and you're showing me that you care by watching my videos. The biggest way for you to help me is to watch my videos, to share my videos, and I thank you guys for that. You guys are amazing people, and this is a beautiful community, and that's why I've always wanted to be straightforward and clear with you on my intentions and on my videos. And I want to thank you guys so much for that. The video you just watched was actually filmed a week ago, but I realized that there's some things I wanted to share with you, and I waited to the end of this video to do that. I wanted to share with you a little bit of a background story, and I wanted to share with you just my thoughts on a certain subject. When I started making my videos 4 years ago, it was common practice to add a PayPal link in the description box. For 4 years, I've had a PayPal link under every single video that I made. I never really thought much about it. And then I started realizing that as I talk about low income and talk about all the things that have been happening in my life, that maybe some people would see that PayPal link and think that I'm trying to e-beg. I have removed all PayPal links from under my videos, all 1,300 videos, and I've done this now for over a week. The reason in doing so is because two things. I'm very conscious of what people think of me. And two, I want people to realize that by having my PayPal on, it was something that was very common, but I didn't feel that maybe it was something that I should be putting on, since I'm talking so much about my videos about saving money and things like that. All of you who watch my channel know how I am and know all about my life and know that I am not an e-bagger. But there are new people that come to my channel and see that, and I don't want to give them a false impression of me. But I do have the PayPal link, and I have it on my banner on my front page, and that's where it will stay. But I'm no longer gonna have a wish list, and no longer am I gonna have a PayPal link at the end of each video in my description box.